Hey YouTube, welcome to video number 2 of rebuilding my little Nix configuration. So in the last video I kind of built the base structure for my little host and we successfully deployed the configuration to a virtual machine over SSH. And just for now I want to start with making a Git repository, and I will divide the videos in different branches so it's easier to follow the code changes. So just let me quickly create a new repo and I make this public and share it with you in the description. And now just initialize a new Git repo and connect it to the remote repo I have just created. And I will just make a new branch for video 1 and just commit everything, send everything to the server. And when we try to reload again, we have the branch video 1 and all the code in here. Now I will just create a new branch for video number 2. And that's how we will be starting today. So at first I want to change a little bit to the structure we were having. So for example, we have this hosts common folder, and the common folder should hold configuration parts that can be shared between machines. And one thing, just from my point of view, which can easily be shared between machines are, of course, user configurations. So what I will do here, I will just create a new folder and name this one users. And what I would like to do now is link the users folders we have in the home directory just within the users folder of the common directory in the hosts part. So I will just create a symbolic link between the two. Now you can see I have this little link symbol up here, and here I have the same files contained as up here. So this is working now. And what I would also like to do is I will create a new Nix file for each user I want to have in here. And within this user file, I want to create the complete user configuration for my host machine. And that also means, of course, that I can go back to the configuration.nix part and can just delete the user here. And as you can see, I have some extra objects in here. For example, I have the initial hashed password. The way you get a password hash is on Linux, you can just go for make password. And I just take 12345 because that's good enough for my machine here, and just replace it here. I have some extra groups assigned. We have network manager because I want to manage network connections. This is for virtualization. This is for using and installing flatpaks. Audio video is self-explanatory. KVM is something that refers to virtualization, and the same for this one here. In the last video, we have uploaded our public key in order to have a passwordless authentication over SSH. And I can actually make this part of my configuration. So I have just saved the public key here. And down here, we have the home manager configuration, which will be imported basically from this file here under home, my username, and then the host name. As you can see here, this is a variable, so this is not hard coded in here. It takes the host name from the configuration we are in right now. So save this one. And as you can see, I have created this file in the wrong directory, so I will just move it into the user directory. And on the users directory, I will create a new default.nix file. And on the default.nix file, on the common directory, I will add imports equal, and then we import the users. And now I will just do a Nix flag check. And this is expected because the flag is looking at the Git repository and we didn't add the new files to the Git repo. So we just do this and try once again. And this error is kind of expected because it tells me we got an unexpected end of file, and that's because the default.nix on this folder is empty. So I will just put an import statement for my username.nix here and do another flag check. And here it's telling us that home manager is not available, and the reason is that we refer to home manager here. We define a home manager user we want to import from our home username folder, and the thing we need to do to fix this is to make home manager available here. So I will head back to common default.nix, and here I will import home manager from the inputs of our flag and just give it some base configuration. So what we do here is we enable user packages and we make the inputs and outputs of the flag available to the home manager configuration. And now we try again. And the flag check succeeded now. And what I can do now is I can just rebuild my configuration. And when I SSH into the server, I can just test if everything is working. If I have a look, if home manager is available. So when I want to test this with the home manager command, we can see this is working. And when I use the generation subcommand, we can see our first home manager generation is already here. When I go to home.nix in my user folder, I have home packages here where I can just select some packages to install into the user space. So I will just this one, packages, and we install cowsay. And now I can just rebuild my configuration here. And this succeeded. And now I can just test this on the server here. And cowsay is installed now. And to not be forced to write packages in front of every package I want to install, I will just add a with packages here, so we can just refer to the package like this and just test it. And you can see this is working. So I will just add all the files and then say git commit video number 2. Just push this. Remove. And now when we have a look at our repo here and look at the latest changes, we have the home.nix. And as you can see on the video 1 where we concluded, we don't have the last changes we made. And when we switch the branches, you can see we have the cowsay here where we concluded with. That's basically a structure I will extend in the next couple of videos. So what we have now is we have installed our VM, we have made the base configuration, and we have created the basic structure to follow a structured approach to build a NixOS configuration. So in the next video, what I would like to do is to build out feature sets. So for example, I have a feature set for coding, and when I enable that at the user, then a fixed configured set of packages will be installed. So that's it for now, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.